गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस लेक्चर इज़ मेन फॉर बीए पार्ट टू इंग्लिश लिटरेचर स्टूडेंट्स एंड आई विल बी डीलिंग विद योर सेकेंड पेपर, दैट इज़ प्रोज एंड फिक्शन. सो स्टूडेंट्स, एज आई हैड ऑलरेडी डिस्कस पर्लेस बर्ग्स द रेफ्यूजीज विथ यू, बट स्टिल आई हैव टू डिस्कस सम इम्पॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस एंड फॉर योर पर्पज ऑफ रिविजन आई अगेन जस्ट टेल यू the few important points and important questions so that you are better well prepared for your exams. Now, as you already know, Perlis Burke belonged to Virginia and her parents were missionaries, and she grew up in China where her parents were missionaries. So she had her education at Randolph Macon College, Virginia, but she returned to China as a missionary. Now see, one thing which is very important, she took a lot of interest in the Chinese peasant. She could feel the problems of agriculture there, and she could feel the problems of the farmers, and she had written a book, you know, The Good Earth. So she even received, what you say, she was the first woman, Perlis Burke, first American woman to win the Nobel Prize for Literature in the year 1938. And The Good Earth, For Good Earth, which dealt with Chinese peasants in 1931, for this work she received Pulitzer Prize, and which is also the very, what you say, very prestigious award in the field of literature. Now this particular story, The Refugees, now The Refugees is also about the refugees who were staying in country. They were very much happy with their own lands, growing their own crops. They were very much in love with their native land, but now they are refugees. They are moving to a capital city, and the problems which they are confronting, okay, because suddenly what you say, calamity of flood has taken over their land, and everything is being, what you say, destroyed, even their food, even their crops, even their houses. So they have to move towards the city, but city, they are coming to the capital and nobody likes them. Even the rickshaw pullers, they have, you know, sort of hatred for these people, because the people, the city people, they bargain with rickshaw pullers because the money which they save. So they try to serve these refugees. So, but the most remarkable thing in this story is a story of an old man. Because how this old man, you know, how he is the one who is so much in love with his own land. He starves himself, he wants to save his grandson, and the money, he receives two coins, that is one copper coin and one silver coin. And you know, he, because his son and his son's wife, they both died when floods came. So to save his starved grandson, he uses one copper coin, buys a small cup of noodles for his grandson, and you know, he doesn't eat, he just licks the bowl. So though he is famished, but why, even the vendor is, you know, wonderstruck that why this old man is doing like this. He wants to help him, but then you know, that vendor thinks, even he's already having a silver coin also along with him, so why should I help him? He can spend that silver coin. But the mystery is, the old man says that I want to save this coin for the seeds which I will buy, and again I'll go back to my native land, I'll go back to my country where I will sow the seeds, so that the future generation, posterity, will be able to survive. So he has that far vision. So this type of vision is certainly, it's very appreciable, and we have to really honor this old man. And that is why this particular story also, it makes such a remarkable impression on our minds, and so much of reverence for this old man. So I will just read out the important lines, as I have already told you the story of the refugees. So Pearl is Burke, she has a great, she writes with so much of what you say, so much of fluency. So when I will read the few lines and then later on I will discuss the important questions, you will realize that. So now see the lines which I will read here for you. Now these lines I would like to read at the end of the story. Well, I know you cannot understand, but you if you had land, you would know it. It must be put to seed again, or there will be starvation yet another year. The best I can do for this grandson of mine is to buy a little seed for the land. Yes, even though I die and others plant it, the land must be put to seed. So now see, if we this is a universal problem. This is a universal problem of the farmers. If we try to connect this, you know, in India itself, though the writer here is writing about the China, the farmers of the China, and the natural calamity of the flood which they are facing. So for us in India, this is the most common problem which our farmers are facing. And till today, the farmers, they are even, you know, they are even, what you say, they are suiciding, and they are, you know, why they are doing this? Because they, their lands, because their lands they consider to be their mother goddess, to be, and they don't have, you know, because of the, what you say, drought, because of the, what you say, famine, because of the floods, when they don't have even the seeds in their hands to sow. So for them, and the loan or the what you say, the loan which they take from the bank, they cannot repay back. So it becomes very difficult for them to survive. So this is the problem which even our Indian farmers are facing. So this is a current universal problem till today of the farmers, because they generally depend on the nature. Now see, some of the important questions, you know, generally during exams you get these short answer questions. The first two questions are, you know, you get 10 questions, and then you also get essay type questions. So I would like to discuss the few important questions with you. Now see, the first one is, that is from your text which is prescribed in your course. Suddenly and by the first one, suddenly and by some unaccountable force, what could have caused the refugees to leave their land? Now, it was the flood which forced them to leave their land. So the second one is, were the refugees really alien to the new capital? Yes, they were, because they came from country, and there are few witnesses also for this. Third one is, name any two things in the new capital which the refugees had never seen before. That is the streets of the capital and the automobiles. But because they are so much engrossed in their own problems, something new also they don't want to vision. This is one. The fourth one is, why did the refugees look at nothing and pass as in a dream? Because they are lost in their own, what you say, own world. They still cannot forget the dream of staying in their own native place. It's a very hard memory for them. The fifth one is, neither did any look at them. Why? Yeah, even the city people, they were not interested in these refugees because they were troubled by them. Nor were these refugees interested in the city people, and neither the city people were interested in them. So this is the most remarkable thing. Now this also shows the indifference, you know. So here we have to consider the point of humanity also. Now sixth, what was the reaction of city dweller who noticed the refugees? Yes, city dwellers, they always wanted to help the refugees, and some of them even didn't feel like helping, but most of them helped. Now, why did the regular rickshaw pullers curse the refugees? Now this is very interesting, because rickshaw pullers are already very, what you say, very poor. So naturally, when these refugees have come to their city, so their, you know, fares are reduced, so that is why they don't like them. What showed that the refugees were all from one reason? Because all these people were wearing the garments which were woven from one blue cotton stuff. So you could make out they all were wearing the same dress, that they are coming from the same reason. What load did the old man carry in the two baskets on his sling? Yes. So I told you the story of an old man. So that old man, he had two baskets. In one basket he had the quilt and the cauldron. And in the other basket he had his own starving grandson, whom he had covered in a quilt. And it was very heavy for him, but he was still carrying. What, the tenth one is, what money did a man passing by give to the old refugee? Yes, old refugee received one copper penny and one silver coin. The 11th one is, why did the old man order only one small bowl of noodles? Yes, because he never wanted to spend the second coin, that is the silver coin, because when they were facing this calamity of flood, even the seeds which they had, you know, retained so that they could grow, you know, they could grow these seeds in their lands. So even those seeds, due to the starving, due to what you say, due to flood, even these seeds were eaten by the small ones. What was the old man's reply when the vendor reminded him, but you have the silver bit? Yes, his reply was that I will go home in my country and I know the value of land and value of seeds, so I'll buy seeds from this coin. Now 13th question is, which line suggests that even the vendor was moved to pity at the sight of the old man? Yes, when the old man was licking the bowl, so this moment really made the vendor very having pity for old man. 14th question is, the passerby's generosity in giving money to the old man has been termed as bitter-heartedness. Why? Yes, it's bitter-heartedness because he wanted to give that money to his father, but now his father is no more, so he is compensating that joy, you know, by giving that money to this old man. So in a way bitter because he doesn't have his own father, but in a way heartiness because he feels that I've helped somebody. Now 15th is, when he saw the silver, he would not put out his hand. What trait of the old man's personality is reflected by this? Now see, this question is very important. This shows that he says, old man says, sir, we are not beggars. We had our own country, we had our own land. I'm not a beggar. You know, my profession is not begging. This is what. So that shows how much of what you say, how much of how dignified and how much of love he is having for his own land. Now, the long question answers which you generally get in exams, so a few which are very important, I will just discuss. Is the refugees a didactic story? What message does it convey? Yes, it's a didactic story. Because after discussing the problem of natural calamity of flood, suddenly it concentrates on the story of an old man. But how that old man, you know, he represents, he's symbolic of regeneration. So that is most important. Now see the second question. You have to elaborate on that. Could one call the old refugee man a beggar coming? Now this question, I feel it to be the most important, because I will ask you students, is that old man a beggar? No, he is not at all a beggar. He is not begging for himself. He is more concerned about his motherland, you know, and he doesn't need the money which he gets. With that, he only supports the child, the posterity, and he wants food for them. So he is not at all a beggar, whereas he is, what you say, he is the giver, not the taker. That is what. So on this you can elaborate very well. So see the third question. These were men and women of which any nation might have been proud, says the narrator about the refugees. Why? Yes, I think so. After listening to the story, after going through the story, you have a lot of respect for this old man. Yes, such men and women, you know, they are principles, they are our idols. This is what I would say. You can elaborate on this with the story. Now see the fourth question. Describe the physical and mental condition of the refugees in the new capital. I told you, psychologically, and if you say physically, mentally, they are beaten. But see this old man. If you see him physically, mentally, he is so tired, but he doesn't give up. So that is the most important thing. Now see the fifth question. What are the most important concerns of the old star man, and how does he show them in his behavior? So for this, it is most remarkable. I'll just to quote from your book, page number 36. I do not ask you, brother, said the old man, to quote, well, I know you cannot understand, but if you had land, you would know it must be put to seed again, or there will be starvation yet another year. Yes, so he has saved for the future. The best I can do for this grandson of mine is to buy a little seed for the land. Yes, even though I die and others plant it, the land must be put to seed. Unquote. Then reading the last two lines, he took up his load again, his old legs trembling, and straining his eyes down the long straight street, he staggered on. So, student, I have in detail discussed the story with you, even the question answers. So, tomorrow I shall be discussing the second story. Thank you for today, students. Thank you for your patience.